Hi, I'm Lucky Magadonna, and welcome to A Little Bit of Leicester. Tonight's guests are Kirk Parliament and Ethan White, and we're going to be talking about the Harvest Fair. Kirk, you've been around for quite a while, around 16 years as chairman of the Harvest Fair. Mm-hmm. Tell, give me a little bit of rundown about the Harvest Fair.
Okay, what I'd like to go through some of the things that are going to happen, and this is pretty much what we've been doing right from the beginning, and that would be that we've had different entertainment up on the stage. This year we're going to have Doolin as one group. They'll be the first ones up, and then Yankee Notions and Slowgrass. We're hoping on getting our Punch and Judy, which has been there, oh my gosh, I think the whole 16 years that we've been doing this.
Are we going to have music throughout the day? Or?
It does go throughout the day. Each group has 2 hours up on the stage, starting at 10 o'clock to their 12, and then 12 to 2, and 2 to 4. So, yeah, we've have done that, and then at some time, well, again, this is the world of change. We've had entertainment in different places, too, but this year is just going to be the three groups up on the stage. And then Punch and Judy will be up by the town hall, where she has normally set up, and then we're hoping to get a balloon, an animal balloon person. Right.
Mm-hmm. Now, Punch and Judy is like a puppet show, I believe.
It is, old-fashioned. As you know, this is a fair that had been based on an old-time fair. So, without bouncing around and getting myself in trouble, the games that we have that are going to be over on Becker property are done by the middle school peer leaders. They're doing things with hoops and sack races, had three-legged races, and they've added a few more. Old-time games to the activities. So they've been great, too. They've been at this fair for a long time.
If I remember right, part of the requirements, and maybe it's changed over the years, is even vendors coming in, they weren't allowed electricity or anything.
Yes, that's true. So it's made it easier on us, but it has it's worked fine. For the 16 years that we've been doing this, everyone's adapted, and now they have their gas grills, and everything's worked fine. So. We're happy.
I've always heard good compliments about the fair.
Oh, the food has been fantastic, and it has changed year to year. One of the things that's been a good thing for them, that they have made their trips out during the fair, because they've run out, and more often than not, you know, 2, 3 o'clock, a lot of people are done, out of food. So, good for them. And a piece of this, too, is that the groups that are doing it are local town organizations. And we have the Congregational Church that does their apple crisp. So, yeah, everybody's doing things to raise money for the group.
For their group.
Yeah.
I actually think LCAC has something coming in. And I believe Parks and Rec is supposed to be putting something in.
Yeah. And the food is to Judy. Judy is our food person.
Yes. It's been interesting the way you've ran it over the years. You have different things going on. You have some vegetable judging, pie judging.
Right.
Can we elaborate on any of that?
I can definitely do that, because that's been a very big part of this, too. We have on Friday night, I forgot the time.
7:30,
thanks.
4 to 7:30.
To 7:30. That the vegetables and the pies and the canned goods that will be dropped off at the town hall. And then we'll fill out cards to keep track of who's bringing what in. And then at that night, we have the judging of the vegetables. Tina Bemis has been doing that right from the beginning of this fair also. Mm-hmm. And then in the morning is when the town representatives, whether selectmen, police, fire, and on, get a chance to judge the pies and the relishes, which has been one thing for a lot of them.
Not just judged on appearance, I take it.
No, definitely taste. And what a neat piece of this, too, is that we've had the banks competing with each other. Another thing that will be mentioned is that Spencer Savings Bank and Country Bank are both represented at the fair, and they've been competing against each other.
So. My understanding is you have, they actually sponsor some activities of yours, too. Mm-hmm.
They do. This year, Spencer Bank is going to be sponsoring Doolin, and Country Bank is going to have the hayride and also pumpkin decorating.
So there's quite a bit going on.
Yeah. We do have the crafters again. They'll be filling up the far side of the common, And then the artisans will be, which we're still waiting for some of them to get their paperwork in, but it looks like everything's set. So we'll have our different artisans that we've had over the years, blacksmith, cooper, tinner, and we're going to have a fiber group, which is we're also going to have, I'm bouncing a little bit here, but we also have a fiber display that's going to be judged inside the Congregational Church along with a photography piece.
And Kurt, by fiber, what do you mean there?
And you're asking a guy this.
Yeah.
More for the ladies, but if we were to look, and I will do another piece that I had my little list.
Yep. We're going to have quilting?
But we do have quilting. The premium book is around the town, and we're also going to have the premium book on the town website.
Yeah.
That was just taken care of today.
And what is a premium book? Just your...
It has a list of the vegetables that we're looking for, the ways to present them, the number of them to be presented, and again, with the canning, the rules for that, and the sauces and the pickles and such. So.
Right, gets into all the different categories of competitions that there'll be, what the guidelines are when you have to drop things off.
Yeah.
One thing I wanted to mention, definitely Kurt, and call out is the fact that this isn't just for adults either. There are children's categories in these competitions also. I know that was one thing that really,
yes.
I mean, my mother's involved in it, but that drew us in. My son is a big gardener, and so he enters every year, and we see a lot more kids year by year that have some, not just vegetables, but canning, they bake pies, they do flower arrangements, and it's a great way for the kids to get some exposure.
Do we do any, I'm gonna say that's part of like 4-H stuff too, but do we have like the rabbit judging or any of this?
We don't have rabbits anymore. We had at one time. This year we're going to have ponies, miniature ponies. And what they'll be doing during the day is having a meet and greet. And then they'll also have a demonstration that they're going to put on. We're not sure what time during the day, but that's going to happen also.
If a meet and greet for us old people, it's like a little petting area.
Yeah, it's like that. But they 4-H has been trying to get away from
the
using
words.
That term. Yeah.
Yeah. But that's what it is, guys. Bring your kids up. They get to see the different animals.
Right.
Yeah.
Face up close. And I don't know if they allow them to feed them, if they have little pellets or anything.
I'm not sure how they're going to go about that. It's a good question. You know, one of the things that I'm just reading about ponies is you got to be careful. And that'll be a great part of learning about it, whether you want to raise them. You don't want to overfeed an animal. Once they put on too much weight, you got a problem.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, just going to feed is not going to be a good thing to do.
We had talked earlier, but should make it clear for the public. These ponies, as you call them, are miniature horses. These are not going to be given out for rides. You're not going to be giving your little kid a ride around the block.
No. They're a good-sized dog would be as big as these ponies are.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. So that's going to be part of the fair.
So a big part of that 4-H piece is an education thing, as much as getting to meet the animals,
so.
To teach kids about how to raise them. And
And maybe they will get interested.
Right, I think that's a big part of the whole event, right, is to get people that maybe aren't interested in agriculture and animals and so forth, get them to see that it's fun and that these things are interesting and challenging and great ways for people to learn responsibility.
How big a committee do you have that actually puts this stuff on?
Well, the committee has, there's probably about 5 or 6 people that have been doing this and doing most of the work. So they've done a phenomenal job. And I couldn't thank them enough for all the energy and time that they put into this fair. So that said, without mentioning all the names, they've been a world of help out here. And again, I thank them from the bottom of my heart for what they do.
Now, do you ever look for extra volunteers?
You know, we would like that. The day of the fair would be a phenomenal thing for people to help out. For those that have been coming to it, you can see how the traffic issue becomes a bit more to handle over the day. Becker College has been very helpful with us through the fair and are going to be helpful with us again this year. Their security, and they have had their nurses come over and do blood pressures, and they've even...
Now, would you have any room for Boy Scouts or Cub Scouts to
help
out?
Oh, they're doing food.
They're doing food, but as volunteers to help out.
Oh, you know, we did used to have them. This again, it's for 16 years, we've had a lot of different things happen. And the Boy Scouts at one time helped. Should have seen their tent take off.
I do remember at one time the Boy Scouts had set up a monkey bridge, what I call a rope bridge.
Yeah, well, they did do a lot. But I think now that they're doing the food to raise money for their organization.
Yeah.
so.
And Ethan, what exactly is your part of this?
Well, yeah, first time this year, we're introducing a brewing competition.
Count me in.
Yeah.
Well, no, I want to be the drinker.
Drinker, right, yeah, the judge.
Yeah.
Yeah, this is the first time we're going to do a home brewing competition. A friend of mine and I, last year when we were up at the Harvest Fair, we're talking to each other because we were getting ready to brew something for October and thought that it would be a great thing to do because we know there are other home brewers in town. And one thing we want to mention too is that it's not just for residents of Leicester. You can be from out of town and can absolutely enter this.
So if you have friends that brew, bring them up.
Exactly.
Now, when do they have to sign up to get their stuff into you?
Yeah, so there isn't a specific sign-up time. It really is they can show up as late as, well, on Friday night to deliver their stuff. Certainly if they have questions, you know, that's something where we'll get my phone number out there as part of this. So if they've got questions about how it works, how to drop things off and so forth, there's information in the guide that Kurt mentioned, which is out around town, and we're actually putting them into a couple of the local breweries and one of the home brewing places as well so that folks can get it there.
But this is strictly going to be private brewers, not the small town brewery or something like this.
Exactly. Yeah, this is meant for amateurs. Right. It's an opportunity for someone that just brews a little bit of beer on the side, come up and show off. And we're working right now on pulling in some judges from the local small breweries and from some of the brewery shops to come in and judge this as well. So you get some professionals to take a look, taste.
So us professionals that used to go up at the Alpine or Legion or whatever, we can't judge for you?
No, no.
I was going to mention, Christy was talking about the rules that are set up for...
Yes. So there are some guidelines. So basically, we have three categories. You've got beer, cider, and mead. So I don't. If you make mead, you know what mead is. not really a popular thing anymore these days.
Yeah.
No. So mead is very definitely a separate category. So those are the three categories. Within them, we didn't break them down into anything further. So like within beer, we're not doing lagers versus IPAs, etc. Yeah. Any kind of beer, it'll all be judged as one category. And there are, and this is in the program as well, there's a website that it's www.bjcp.org, and we'll get that in as part of this as well. But you can go to that website to see more information. We're using that standard as our judging standard. Mm-hmm. So you can go to that website and get more information about what you're getting judged on, how they differentiate one category versus another so that they can tell what flavors should
this
be.
This is the first time out there.
Yep.
And obviously we can't serve to the public because of license and stuff. I mean, I like kidding around.
Yeah.
But you are going to have professional judges come in.
Right.
They are going to judge. Now, how much? I have to bring a six pack if I brew it, or how's that work?
Nope, it's just one bottle, one 16-ounce bottle. Certainly, we're not picky on color. It needs to be unmarked, because one thing you will get judged on is the clarity of the beer.
Okay.
So it's appearance, aroma, taste, and what they refer to as mouthfeel.
Yeah.
So we all know when we drink a beer that does not have a good mouthfeel. Okay. So those are the four kind of high-level categories. But yeah, it's just one 16-ounce bottle. And you'll be judged on that.
Have you had a big turnout so far? People?
We haven't had, no. So far, don't really know anything yet. We haven't been contacted by anybody saying they're doing it. So that's another reason why, we're trying to get a feel so we know what to expect. But I think it'll be really good. I think, like I said, my friend John and I certainly know other people in town that brew. And I think it's a great chance for the amateur to see, they may like their beer, but what is it thought of really?
Now we think back to like the old Three Stooges movies or Laurel and Hardy's and stuff like that where people would brew beer in their cellar and all of a sudden they have the big explosion.
Right.
Does that still happen today?
No, not anymore. But home brewing has really taken off. So, there's a place up in Marlboro, one in West Boylston. They sell supplies, but they also do courses and education and everything. So most people that are getting it in with the internet too obviously makes it a lot easier not to make a mistake. Now certainly, occasionally bottles will blow up, things like that in a basement. But I think most people are smart enough not to have their propane burner in their basement when they're making their batch that's outside. And that's actually something else I wanted to mention is that John Bujak and I, the two that have been we're working on this, we're gonna do as part of the folks that are out demonstrating on the common, we're gonna actually come up and do the beginning stages of brewing. So we'll bring some equipment up and make a batch.
Well, actually, anybody's interested in brewing, and I have had friends that do brew.
Yep.
It is quite a process.
It really is. And yeah.
It takes time, and if you rush it, it's
not
terrible.
Good. Yep.
It's not good. But you take your time. There's some really good home brews out there.
Yeah, and one of the things that we'll be trying to demonstrate by doing it out on the common there is to, it does take time. You need to think about things, but it's not intimidating.
Mm.
It's not, it's time consuming, but it's not hard. And it really is a couple of mornings over the course of about 6 weeks,
right.
Doing each of the steps in the process. But it's something that anybody can do if you like beer. Cost-wise, it winds up probably being about the same,
right.
Unless you start growing your own grain and right, and your own hops and things. But
now, can you still buy those old-fashioned bottled hop caps?
Absolutely.
You can.
That's what
I have
use.
An actually
yep.
antique one in my cellar.
Yeah. Yep. No, absolutely. And that one other thing I did want to mention, too, Kurt and I were talking about it earlier. The goal, because I'm sure if you do home brewing, there are kit beers where you can buy a box that basically has all the ingredients pre-measured, and you're going to get this beer.
Mm-hmm.
And as long as you can follow directions, you can make that
beer. Like baking a cake.
It really is, like baking a cake. And just like in the pie competitions, you're not supposed to pop open a box of ready mix and throw it in a pan. We're looking for people, while they don't have to use raw grain per se, you could use an extract and things like that in the process. We're not looking for you to come up and show us that you can make a Budweiser replica with your kit.
Right.
We're looking for home brews, so true varieties that you've come up with on your own, things that you do special to those beers that make them yours.
Makes them yours.
Yeah, yep.
And finishing up with something of this, what we have done with all the pies and the vegetables, we haven't talked about the beer, is that we do auction them off at the end of
right.
the fair. That's one way that we raise money for the following year.
I was going to say, you don't get town funded for this.
No. No, we get grants and we do charge fees to the crafters, and then we pay the artisans and obviously the bands.
Mm-hmm. So if I wanted to enter the pie, what's it cost to enter a pie?
There's no cost to enter a pie.
No.
But it's
losing your pie.
You're going to lose your pie.
Yeah, lose.
You can get the ribbon though.
Yeah.
You get the ribbons, first prize or whatever. Yeah. We used to be getting a large pumpkin. And he was walking away with the rosette.
Now, earlier you mentioned Mrs. Bemis does the vegetable.
Yeah.
Is this from Bemis Nursery?
It is.
She's very knowledgeable on the vegetables.
Oh, very knowledgeable.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Yep. Yes.
Yeah, she's very involved in 4-H, too. Mm.
Now, some of the other things you're going to have, you had mentioned you're going to have the small ponies or miniature horses. You're going to have some blacksmithing, some coopers.
Right, right.
But you're also going to have the fire department up this year.
Yes, that's something that we've been working on with Mr. Wilson. I know that he's not in town right now, but their plan is to have all three fire departments up on Old Main, lining the road. And then as far as the activities go, I would not want to say, but they do plan on being there the day.
They're going to be there the day, my understanding, and I just happen to be texting with Mr. Wilson, and they're bringing what they call the safe trailer up.
Yes.
And what the safe trailer is, it's to teach kids how to, we used to say stop, right. drop, and roll.
Yeah.
But how to teach kids to get out of a house, go through what a smoky house would look like.
Right.
It's a lot of educational. It's fun for the kids, and it's an easy training thing. Mr. Wilson's been doing the DARE program. I forget what they call it exactly for the fire department.
Yeah.
It's not DARE.
But he's been doing it for years, as far back as I can remember, where he's been going to different schools and stuff and teaching kids all about fire and fire safety.
Yep.
He's very good at it. The people most likely he's going to have help him have been doing it for years. It's a very educational program, and it's fun for the kids to do.
Yeah. Right. And it's not even just great for the kids, but I mean, personally, I've never been in a burning building before. But yeah, we went to the safe house when they had it down at Rochdale 1 year. And as a parent, just going in and experiencing what it's like, what a smoky room is like, it takes that fear away. And now, if something, God forbid, ever were to happen, you're not quite as panicked as you would be without having an experience.
Exactly.
Yeah. And maybe they'll do a muster, too.
Yeah.
Well, you never know. They might
do a little
muster.
Would be nice. Yeah.
Yeah. People do love watching musters.
They do.
Absolutely.
And actually, I understand they did pretty good at when they went to last week or week before. They took home a bunch of trophies.
Oh, no kidding.
Lester's always, if anybody happens to go down to any of our stations in town, you look up on the walls, we have trophies and plaques all over from musters.
Yeah.
I can't say enough about the Lester Fire Department.
Okay. I don't know if there's any.
I am trying to get you some recruits. I mean, you people, and I don't want to use the word loosely, you guys are getting old. You've been around for quite a while, and new blood always helps. People bring in new ideas. Like Ethan, you're bringing in the beer thing. Yep. I mean, I had one years ago, and I never pursued it.
Yeah.
Was going to be a model car. At the time, model cars were big model airplanes.
Yeah.
A model building competition. I remember Master Hobbies at one time. We had remote control cars with Mike and Dolcom. I can't think of Mr. McLeod. Norman.
Yeah, Norman. Yep.
Running it. We did it in the town hall. We had remote control car races. So there's always something that if people want to do something and they step forward, you let them organize it.
Oh,
and if
sure.
it's feasible,
right. yeah.
it's helpful.
Well, that said, we would love to see this fair continue on. It's been a great hit for the town. It is, though, something, and I want to sound negative on it, but we can't do this forever.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not saying that for people to jump on board and be on the committee, but just helping us out during the day would be a phenomenal thing for us. We have a lot to pick up. We have a lot to set up and then maintain during the day.
Mm-hmm.
Right. Now, does the committee sell waters or anything like that? Is that somebody else's organization?
No, we don't sell. It's for everybody else to make their money.
Right.
We do have a few things that we have sold. There's some cats meows that we have, a couple books. There's diner prints that we've been doing. But we don't get involved in a lot of...
No.
Oh, we did bags, too. We had tote bags.
Okay. Yeah. Now, also, I'm going to ask you about the committee. If you were to join your committee, how often do you meet?
Well, that being that we have been doing it for 16 years, we meet starting in June. That's usually when we start.
Yeah.
This is not a year-round activity.
Right.
I know we have to get more of it documented as to what we all do, but it's not something that we're meeting from the end of our fair till the following fair.
Yeah.
It's
right.
We meet once a month, and we only do that starting in usually June.
It's not like a basic town committee. I know the town's always looking for people to get on their committees.
Yeah.
But time is of the essence to people.
Yeah.
Yes.
And they can't commit one, two nights a week
right.
for 12 months.
True.
No, yeah, this is only, what, once a month once you start?
More. Oh, yeah.
So it's even once you start the meetings. And I think, you know, well, you guys aren't looking to get out or run away from
this by any means.
But getting people involved now, they have a chance to
learn what we're doing. Yeah,
so it's not intimidating. You don't feel like you have to take on a leadership role. Just be part of the program and support it. And
not having them reinvent the wheel. Is
right,
the
exactly.
Saying.
Yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah, I was going to say one other thing. We are an ad hoc committee. We're all Arts Council members, too. And I shouldn't say that. We're not all. But the majority of us are Arts Council members.
Members.
Yeah.
So, not a requirement, though.
No, it is not.
And we are looking for day help, if possible.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, if possible.
Yeah.
Hey, we'll get through the day.
Yeah.
We know what we're up to. So.
And, I mean, if they came up, they could see you at the Common?
Yeah, well, the people that you'll be looking for, they'll be wearing orange shirts that do have Harvest Fair emblems on them.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, we stick out pretty much.
So if you had a teenage son or a teenage daughter, why don't
we have done that. I'm glad you mentioned that. I almost forgot that. We do give opportunities for young people, high school, that have to do their community service.
Yep.
That they can come to the fair and do things.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah.
And you actually have a high school member of the committee,
we
right?
We do, yes. Yeah. She's been, we're going to have her for a couple of years. But she's on the high school art committee. Did I leave them out? I did.
Yes.
They are the ones, the high school art group is going to be doing face painting that day, and also they do have some other activities they're planning on putting together.
Mm.
But they've been a great help too, because they set the artwork up in the town hall on Friday night and then break it down the next day. So yeah, the high school's been great, but anybody else, we've had a number of people and sometimes we have none.
Yes.
But if you have to do community service, we'll be more than happy.
Now, what exactly times does this start and when does it actually end?
It's 10 to 4. 10 to 4, cool. Yeah. And for those that keep saying, why don't you do it 2 days? one day for the committee, and it's, you know, we're glad to see everyone happy at the end of the day, but it's It's a lot of work.
It is.
It's a lot of work.
I often wondered, I mean, it's only a fairly new committee, but you have the Harvest Fair going on, and we also have, lack of a better word, Founders Day.
Right.
If they ran them both together and...
You know, we thought about that when I was saying, you know, where do we go with this? How do you make this work? And we bounced it around. I don't know that at this point that's part of, you know, either group's plan, but I never say never.
Because I know, I mean, personally, I love the Founders Day, what they do with it. I like the Civil War reenactment they did this year. You guys do a heck of a job with your Harvest Fair. I've been up a few times. Most of the time I'm away on vacation, sorry to say. But I am going to be home for this one. I want to see that beer. you guys do a heck of a job. And Judy Ivel does a heck of a job. I don't know if she's still actually running the Concert on the Commons.
But oh, yes, she is. Yeah. Yes.
She does a heck of a job with the Concert on the Commons.
Agreed. Yeah.
You know, it's hard to find people that want to put the time in and do such a good job.
And it does take time. Mm-hmm. You've got to really be devoted to what you're doing. You know?
Yeah, but I think a lot of people think of it as more than it is. It's a lot of time, there's no doubt about it, but it's not a nightly thing.
Consumed by it
right,
every day.
Right, exactly. So.
But, yeah, I mean, it's a big turnout for the kids. I mean, you don't have little stuff like this in Worcester. Worcester kids don't have a chance to see the miniature ponies.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Or at one time you had sheep shearing.
Yeah.
You know, inner city kids don't get that opportunity. We're lucky to have towns like Leicester, Spencer, Oakham or Petersham. That's a big one.
You're right.
There's
a lot of that's where we got the idea from too. You know, we are not sanctioned. That's one of the things with the vegetables that we can't pay money out, as the Spencer Fair does and others.
Right.
But it's still a lot of fun to see what people have grown for the day of the year and.
Yep, absolutely.
Give them credit for credits too.
Right.
And
absolutely.
There's a lot of upcoming young ladies and young men for that.
Yeah.
That's set in the cooking. I mean, cooking seems to, from what I can see on the internet and stuff, everybody's attempting to cook today and try their hand at something.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
And it's an opportunity for they can see how good they do.
Exactly.
Or jellies.
Yep.
Yeah, the canning, we had one older gentleman that he used to bring a big box full of stuff. I haven't seen him. He's an older gentleman, but that's a great piece too. You know, now in the world where you want to preserve what you put up,
right?
It's nice.
Yeah,
exactly. You know, I look around town. Not that it has to do like with Harvest Fair so much, but more and more people are getting into their home gardens and chickens.
Yeah.
Every place I look, somebody has a small chicken coop in their backyard.
We haven't done eggs yet.
How would you judge an egg?
Oh, no, we do eggs. Don't they? I'm wondering if there's eggs.
Because
Diane Preventure. We do have a farmer's market. Did that get out there too?
No, we didn't mention that.
Yeah, the farmer's market.
And is it just going to be Diane, or is it going to be different people?
We do have a couple people that are doing it, but Diana will be there. Yeah. Why did I tell? Well, maybe they were at the Spencer Fair, the eggs.
Yeah.
Yeah, we don't have eggs.
And we say Diana, for those in town should know who Diane Preventure is.
Yeah.
But she has that little farm, I think it's called Little Bitty Farm.
A Little Bit.
On Little Bit Farm, up on Charles Street.
Yeah.
And she does eggs, she does turkeys.
Right, and she has the farmer's market at the castle.
And she has the
farm. On Saturdays. Right.
On Saturdays. She's a quite active lady.
Yeah.
I mean, I'll put a plug in for Diana. If you're out there and you want fresh vegetables or you want to... Turkey, put your name in now, and see her.
Mm-hmm.
She does marvelous. She's a great person to work with.
Yep.
So I think that's, as far as I know, I'm about wrapped up.
I was going to mention just a couple of other quick things. Locations where premium books can be picked up, Kurt?
Oh, or they're in the town hall, they're in the library, they're in the banks. They're also at the post offices. And then we have done some local businesses, Evergreen, Everlast, rather.
Yep.
And
Breezy Bend.
Yes.
Yeah.
Breezy and
Bend.
The garden, farm and garden.
Yep.
Thank you.
Agwood.
Yep.
Okay.
Yeah. Blankish.
Yep.
So they're out there, and again, the premium book is supposed to be put on the town website.
Yeah.
So that was just done today, where I got the paperwork.
Well, as you know or probably don't know, I mean, we call my show A Little Bit of Leicester now, but originally I was going to be calling it Spend It in Leicester. And reason I wanted to call it that is we have all these local places, like you mentioned, yeah. Breezy Bend's, right. Everlast, Little Bit of Farm, the Nursery Down the Valley, right. D&G. All these people, at one time or another, contribute to everything in this town. Every time right. we turn around,
yeah. yep.
they look at, they'll give you a donation, you know,
right.
and they get hit up time and time again. And I really do like to see people spend their money in Leicester.
In town, absolutely.
We have almost everything. I mean, you want a body shop? We have a body shop. You want a garage? We have a garage. You want a farm? We have
dairy farm.
Dairy yeah. farm.
Yeah.
We have everything you need. We have yep. a Walmart, even though I don't consider that part of Leicester. We do have a Walmart in town. There's really no reason to have to go outside of Leicester to spend your money.
True. Right. Yep.
True, true.
Absolutely true. Right.
Well, anything else you guys would like to throw in at this time?
Only other thing I was going to mention is there is no limit on how many things you enter.
Right.
So
yeah, oh yeah,
yeah. Like for instance, for the beer yes. competition, you can enter more than one variety. That's fine. For the vegetable, I mean, you can do the vegetables. You can do all the different canning categories. Yep. The baking competition, all the different categories, and the premium book outlines all that. But yeah, there's no limit on how many things you can try. So if you're, if you've got a lot yeah. of different talents, yeah. show them off.
Now, is there any carpentry type stuff?
No, we are trying to get a wood carver to demonstrate, but there's nothing done in the carpentry end of it.
Yeah.
Okay. No. Wood carving is very interesting. I carved for years
agree.
Doing
yeah, yeah.
Absolutely.
I've been that's been one of the hardest things, and there's people that do it all around here.
Yeah.
But I've not been able to get one to commit.
There is, I can't think of a place in Auburn. They actually run classes.
Yeah. Well, there's one in Spencer that does wood carving. I went to them. No more.
He unfortunately, Tom McGregor passed away 4 years ago.
No kidding.
Yes.
Well, I went there probably 7 years ago trying to get them. And,
well, I probably had you in one of my classes because that's where I learned how to carve around.
Okay. Well, I was trying to. Okay.
Yeah.
But we do have somebody that we've been calling. I don't know how that'll play out.
Yeah. I'll look up a few names. I have some people I still
know. That would be great. You know, and that could be for others if some people have a demonstrator that they'd like to see. And we, as I say, we do pay them. We don't. I mean, it's not like we have deep pockets, but we do pay people for demonstrating. And it doesn't have to be all day. It's just certain sections of the day. We have a basket person. I did leave that out, too.
So the toll painters? Or
no, we haven't done that either. We did have painters at one time, but they were from the village.
They were from the village, yeah.
But they, you know, a lot of the people that I've approached initially had worked at Sturbridge Village and
there
since moved on.
There is a lot of different talents that could be demonstrated up here, and people would love to see how it's done.
Oh, sure. It is amazing to see how they just stay in front of these ladies or guys doing whatever they're doing and watch.
I know I had done a show with Mr. McGregor. It used to be Waterfowl Creations. We were doing a show down, the sports show, down the Centrum years back. There was three of us put it on. And very interesting. And a lot of people couldn't believe what you could do with a piece of wood.
Yeah. Well,
and there's a lot of talented people in town, so it's a chance to...
Yeah.
Well, the sign that's out front here was carved by somebody in town, and I'm trying to get her to.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
There's so much talent out there, and people do like to show it off, but they don't know they have this venue where they could show it off.
Well, it's out there now, whether they've seen it here or heard about it. We'd like to get more demonstrators out there.
Well, I really want to thank you guys for coming in tonight. It's been a pleasure talking with you and learning a little bit more about stuff that happens in our town and the Harvest Fair. I'm really interested in this brewery. I hope it really takes off good.
Me too.
Along with everything else, but we're going to wrap it up now and let them know. I'm Lucky Magadonna with Kurt Parliament and Ethan White. And we're wishing you a good night, and make sure you make the Harvest Fair. And that is
September 19th.
September 19th, 2015, 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. Hope to see you there. Good night.